In this video, I will show you how to update the BIOS on an Asus motherboard using the BIOS Flashback method. This can be done on a fully assembled PC or just a motherboard with no components attached. I will be using an already assembled PC since that is the only Asus motherboard we have at this time. If you are doing this on an assembled PC, you do not power up the computer at any point during the update process. Do note that after the BIOS update, it will be reset to factory defaults, so any custom settings you will want to note down or back up your settings, which we will not cover in this video. If you are doing on a new motherboard without components, you will just need a power supply connected with the 24-pin ATX power. The required items for the update is the motherboard or PC that you're going to be updating the BIOS on, a USB drive, 32 gigabytes or less, and preferably USB 2.0, but 3.0 will usually work. Power supply and a PC connected to the internet to prepare your USB drive. The first thing we're going to do is insert and format the USB drive. So after inserting the USB drive into your computer, you should see it listed with your other drives. We're going to right-click on the USB drive listed and select Format from the context menu. You want to make sure that the file system selected is FAT32, and you should be able to leave the rest of the options as their defaults. You can then click on the Start button to start formatting the drive. When the warning pops up about erasing all data on the disk, click OK. After a few seconds, you should get the Format Complete dialog, and you can click OK. You can then close the Format dialog, and we can move on to downloading the BIOS file. Go to the support page for your specific motherboard, and go to the Support tab. From here, go to Drivers and Tools, and then the BIOS and Firmware section. At the top of the list, you will find the latest BIOS. If looking for a previous one, you will need to expand the section to find the one you are looking for. Once you've selected the BIOS that you're updating, click on the Download button and save it directly to the USB drive you previously formatted. Once the file is downloaded, navigate to the USB drive and right-click on the zip file and select Extract All from the context menu. To make things easier, delete everything after the backslash so it is extracted to the top-level directory. Then click Extract. After a few seconds, it should finish. You can then delete the zip file. Double-click on the BIOS renamer.exe file to rename the update file, and once done, press any key. You should now have a renamed update file, and you can delete the renamer file, so just the BIOS update is on the USB drive. Now safely eject the USB drive, and we are ready to update the motherboard. If updating a motherboard without components installed, all you need to do is connect the ATX 24-pin connector. Next, we'll attach the power cable to the power supply and switch on the power supply. And remember, if your PC is already assembled, do not power it up. At this point, you want to locate the USB port that's specific for the BIOS update, which will be marked, and insert the USB drive into that USB port. Next, locate the BIOS flashback button. Press and hold for a few seconds and the light should start flashing. At this point, you should see the BIOS light flashing, and also if you look at the USB drive, you'll see that light flashing as well. At this point, we're just going to leave the motherboard. This can take several minutes. If the light only flashes for a very brief time and then stops, most likely the BIOS update did not happen. In this case, it is best to try a different USB drive and see if that is the issue. And during the process, you do not want to interrupt, press the power on the PC or anything. Best bet is just to walk away and let it do its thing. And at this point, I'll speed up the video until it's complete. Now that the lights have stopped flashing, we gave it a short period of time, and then we'll remove the USB drive and reboot the system to see if the update succeeded. And as we can see here, the BIOS is updated to the latest version, and we're all set. We hope you found this video helpful and appreciate you watching. Please support us by subscribing if you found this helpful. Thank you for watching.